Hello friends, welcome to engineering tutorial. So we will continue our discussions with the power systems engineering, and so far we have discussed various introductory concepts related to the basic fundamentals of power systems and the various aspects, sources of energy, basic principle of conversion of the primary energy source into electrical energy, and about the various units of energy, basic concepts. So in this video we are going to discuss about another important concept, which is mainly related to fuels as the main source of energy. So basically we are talking about coal, oil and natural gas as the primary energy source. So this is related to that. Okay, so we know that the sources of energy, the primary source of energy, it can be of the following types: sun, wind, water, fuels and nuclear energy. So here our discussion is centered around fuels, okay, the calorific value of fuels. So before that, let us just have a quick look at the basic principle of energy generation. So all these primary energy sources, in order to convert it into electrical output, which is our objective, so we need to convert it into some kind of a mechanical energy, mechanical form, some kind of a rotation or anything like that. And then using the principle of generation, generator, we convert it into electrical energy using a prime mover and alternator combination. So prime mover, it can be an internal combustion engine, it can be different types of turbines, rotating turbines, and alternator is basically an AC electrical generator. Okay, so the basic elements of energy generation, it involves the primary energy source, which can be the sun, wind, water, fuels and nuclear energy. Then the prime mover, which converts it into some kind of a mechanical motion, converting it to mechanical energy. And alternator is basically an AC electrical generator. Okay, so it can be the kinetic energy of blowing winds, the potential head of water, the chemical energy of the fuels, or the nuclear energy of radioactive substance. Okay, so the prime mover, the examples, which in this case, in case of fuels and steam power plants that are used in various, be it coal, natural gas, or oil, petrol or diesel power plants. So it can be steam turbines or gas turbines or petrol or diesel engines. The prime movers can be that. An alternator is basically an AC electrical generator, which converts the mechanical energy into electrical output. Okay, now where does calorific value come into play? Okay, so basic, we will discuss about the power plants related to fuels in detail in step by step manner, but let me just give you a quick overview of that. So basically what happens is that the fuel is first burnt to generate sufficient amount of heat energy, and that heat energy, it is used to boil water, which can be used to generate steam. And when sufficient amount of steam is generated at a sufficiently high pressure, that is used to rotate turbines. Okay, the force produced by the steam at high pressure, and that rotation of the turbine, which generates or which gives us this mechanical output, the mechanical energy, that is converted into electrical energy using the alternator. So here, the more the amount of heat generated because of the combustion of the fuel will result in more amount of steam, and more the amount of steam means more the pressure or force produced because of that steam. It means more the mechanical output. More the mechanical output means more the electrical output. Okay, so the amount of heat energy is directly proportional to the mechanical output, and the mechanical output corresponds to a equal electrical output. Okay, so calorific value is basically the amount of heat generated by the complete combustion of a unit weight of fuel. Okay, so it is the amount of heat energy available from a fuel. So the more the calorific value, the more is the ability of that fuel to produce heat. Okay, so it is the amount of heat energy produced by the complete combustion of a unit quantity of fuel. So the various types of fuels that are used for energy generation, it can be solid fuels, coal mainly, liquid fuels, diesel, petrol, heavy oil, gaseous fuels, natural gas, coal gas. So the calorific value of fuels are mainly we have already discussed about the various units of energy that are used for practical purposes in the previous video. So you please check out that video first. There I have discussed about the various units of electrical energy, mechanical energy and heat energy, the thermal energy. So please check out that video. So basically the calorific value for the solid and liquid fuels are represented in kilocalorie per kg, and for gaseous fuels it is represented in kilocalorie per cubic meter. So for coals, mainly there are three types means which are used for power generation, that is lignite, bituminous and anthracite coal. So they have calorific values with 5000 kilocalorie per kg, 7600 kilocalorie per kg and 8500 kilocalorie per kg. So that is solid fuels. Then the liquid fuels, diesel, petrol and heavy oil. So heavy oil has a calorific value 11000 kilocalorie per kg. Diesel oil has 11000, almost around. It's not, see, these values, it can be little bit more or less, but it has an average value of this 11000 kilocalorie per kg. And petrol also more or less the same, 11100 kilocalorie per kg. For natural gas and coal gas, the gaseous fuels, they have calorific values 520 kilocalorie per cubic meter and 7600 kilocalorie per cubic meter. Okay, so it means on the complete combustion of a unit quantity of these fuels, this much amount of energy will be generated, heat energy will be generated. Okay, so now let us have a quick look at the advantages of liquid fuels and solid fuels, basically in relation in comparison with each other. So liquid fuels are basically easy to handle, less storage space is required, the combustion happens in a uniform way, in a homogeneous way, and they are relatively burnt with ease as compared to the solid fuels, produce very little or no ash, you know, and the firing of these fuels can also be easily controlled. So in relation with solid fuels, now solid fuels also have certain advantages in comparison with the liquid fuels. They are cost efficient, there is no danger of explosion which is there in liquid and gaseous fuels. They're highly flammable, so there is a risk of explosion or fire caused because of those fuels. And solid fuels, the coal and different types of coal, they can be used in a variety of weather and climatic conditions, whereas liquid fuels, they have a specification related to how much temperature and how much pressure, surrounding temperature and pressure, which is required for their combustion. Also, no special burners are required for the combustion of solid fuels. Okay, but liquid and gaseous fuels, they have that requirement. Okay, so here I just wanted to discuss in short about this concept of calorific value, and here we discussed about the calorific value of the commonly used fuels used for power generation. So I hope you like this video. And please subscribe my channel Engineering Tutorial for more such videos related to electrical, electronics, instrumentation and communication engineering. Have a great day. Thank you very much.